A Philippine military official says Manila's joint drills with its allies are helping the country be prepared in case a war breaks out. But Balikatan 2024 Executive Agent Colonel Michael Lojico clarifies the training exercises are not a response to China's aggression in the West Philippine Sea. This year's Balikatan exercises is expected to be the largest ever, with around 11,000 American soldiers and 5,000 Filipino troops expected to participate. It is also the first time France will be joining the drills.
The armed forces has a mandate to defend our territory, and there is an adjunct to that mandate, which is you have to train for it. And for realistic training, we train in areas where realism is provided for. The purpose of an armed forces, why we exist, is really to prepare for war. There's no sugarcoating it. An intrusion into our exercise area is a possibility, but that will pose more of a problem for the people who want to enter the exercise area, not us. Because we're going there with our Navy vessels, so with the United States and also with the French Navy. We're going there prepared.
This year's Balikatan exercises will run from April 22 to May 10. Now, as for China, it says the joint drills between the Philippines and U.S. forces will only lead to what it called greater insecurity for Manila. Beijing's foreign ministry warns the Philippines bringing other countries in a show of force in the South China Sea will only aggravate tensions and undermine regional stability. China asserts it will continue to staunchly defend its maritime rights, calling the exercises another provocation by Washington and Manila. Philippine authorities alarmed over an alleged influx of Chinese nationals in the country. Surigao del Norte representative Robert Ace Barbers claims Chinese individuals pretending to be Filipinos are buying huge tracts of land near major ports and military sites in the country. Aside from this, state forces say they are investigating the reported surge in the number of Chinese students in Cagayan to determine if their presence possesses a threat to national security.
And sabi nga, estudyante to. So kung meron ba silang student visas that are required. So we are coordinating with the Bureau of Immigration, the DFA, and since students to, sir, no, pati yung CHED.
Progressive House lawmakers also seeking a probe into the alleged existence of Chinese sleeper cells or agents working undercover in the Philippines. Beijing has repeatedly denied the allegations.
Kunyari ay estudyante, kunyari sila ay mga pangkaraniwang mamamayan, pero meron silang mga skills na pang-spy o military skills na later on naman kung gagamitin sila ay mabubuhay sila. Mga ito yung mga sleeper cell. Tingin natin ay baka meron ng ganyan dito sa Pilipinas, kaya tuloy lahat ng kumbaga yung mga kilos ng natin dito sa Pilipinas
namamatsaga
ay
nila.
Parang tansyado na ng China, no? Nakakakaba na, nakaka-worry na itong mga ganitong mga nangyayari.
The Philippine Supreme Court orders the Senate to comment on a petition of fugitive televangelist Apollo Quiboloy. The pastor is seeking a temporary restraining order against what he calls an unconstitutional arrest warrant. Willard Cheng tells us more.
The Supreme Court has directed the Senate to comment on the petition for certiorari and prohibition filed by Kingdom of Jesus Christ founder Pastor Apollo Quiboloy to declare the arrest and detention order of the Senate as null and void. The Senate earlier issued the arrest order after Quiboloy refused to attend hearings into allegations of abuse against the religious leader. Quiboloy claimed the Senate investigation is not in aid of legislation, saying it's a usurpation of judicial functions beyond the powers of the Senate.
The respondents in this case, they were required to file a comment within 10 days on the petition, as well as the prayer for the issuance of the TRO and the writ of preliminary injunction. So right now, it's at that stage. We are awaiting the comment of the respondents.
Respondents of Quiboloy's petition include Senate President Juan Miguel Subiri, Senator Risa Ontiveros, who chairs the Committee on Women, Children, Family Relations, and Gender Equality, and the Senate Sergeant-at-Arms. Senator Ontiveros says she is ready to answer any order of the Senate and that her counsel, former Senior Associate Justice Antonio Carpio, will study and respond as soon as possible. While she has yet to receive a copy of the court's order, Ontiveros expressed readiness to comply with the SC directive in respect of the court and in recognition of the principle of separation of powers. A principle, she says, that should also guide Quiboloy. Former Senate President Franklin Drilon points out that since the Supreme Court did not issue a TRO, Quiboloy should now face the Senate.
The Senate could have been stopped by the Supreme Court through a temporary restraining order prayed for by Quiboloy. The fact that the court refrained from using that power is an indication that it is their view that Quiboloy is not entitled to that immediate relief, without prejudice, of course, to finally deciding the case on its merit.
He adds, the failure of authorities to fine Quiboloy affects the credibility of the justice system.
This is a slap on the executive branch, particularly the enforcement of orders, and this does not augur well for our people's confidence in our court system.
Quiboloy's camp has yet to issue a response. Willard Cheng, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Justice Department denies influencing witnesses to testify against former congressman-turned-fugitive Arnolfo Teves Jr. His lawyer, Ferdinand Topacio, claims Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla is tampering with the witnesses. Topacio says he has reliable information that Remulla is offering them what he called substantial sums or intimidating and coercing them to testify. Justice Department spokesperson Nico Clavano dismissed Topacio's statement as misleading. Clavano says the evidence against Teves is strong. He described Topacio's statements as those of a lawyer who thinks his client is guilty. Teves is pushing back against his deportation to Manila after his arrest in Timor-Leste on March 21. He faces 10 counts of murder over the killing of former Negros Oriental Governor Roel Degamo and 9 other persons. Now let's get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Anna Clauren. Good morning, Anna.
Yes, good morning. For our weather forecast today here in Metro Manila and the rest of the country, we're expecting a general fair weather condition aside from isolated rain showers mostly in the afternoon or in the evening. Currently, we're not monitoring any weather disturbance that may affect the country. And for the temperature forecast here in Metro Manila, the temperature will range from around 24 to 35 degrees Celsius. In Baguio City, 18 to 27 degrees. And in Tagaytay, is 23 to 33 degrees Celsius. And that's the latest from PAGASA. This is Anna Clolen. Good morning.
Thank you very much for that update, Anna.